Start with decision tables. This is a common way for getting your head wrapped around a situation where there are various different states that can affect ultimate behavior of the system. If you think about decision tables in terms of input conditions and responses to those inputs, that is combinations of inputs yielding results. That's where the term combinatorial comes from. The table will have columns, some of which correspond to the inputs, and the remainder will correspond to the outputs. And then each of the rows is going to correspond to a different combination of input values. Let's imagine that we have a workshop and there are three switches. Okay? Each of the switches can have on and off as possible values. Okay? So we're going to have three columns and eight rows. Where did the eight come from? Well, if we have three switches, two possible values for each switch, that's 2 to the 3rd or 8. Let's assume that the three switches control two output devices, maybe an overhead light and maybe a power drill. The third switch is a master switch, which controls all the electricity in the workshop. Well, here's a decision table for this situation. I partitioned the columns into three input columns for the three different switches and two output columns for the lights and the motor on the power drill. Each of the rows corresponds to one of the possible combinations of values for the input switches. 2 to the 3rd, 8 different rows there. For each of the combinations of the inputs, there'll be a resulting situation as far as the outputs are concerned. So for example, if the master control switch is off, then it doesn't matter the positions of the other switches, both the lights and the motor will be off.